Why is the government directly awarding a 50 megawatt solar plant project to One Malaysia Development Berhad despite past controversies and pledges? Fresh from being awarded an estimated 11 billion ringgit contract involving a 2,000 megawatt coal-fired power plant project called Project 3B, despite a marginally higher bid at 25.65 cents per kilowatt per hour as compared to its competitor at 25.23 cents per kWh, 1MDB is again being confirmed a 50 megawatt solar plant project, albeit through direct tender this time around. The mega solar power plant being initiated by One Malaysia Development Berhad has secured a tariff rate of somewhere between 40 cents to 46 cents per kilowatt per hour. The rates are lower than existing tariff for electricity generated by solar plants. Electricity generated from non-subsidized gas would cost about 35 cents. We could assume that the government's strategy is to displace gas when subsidy withdrawals take place as part of the subsidy rationalization program. And of course, 1MDB is their best friend in doing this. However, it cannot be determined if that is the best rate with present technology, because it is learned that this is a directly negotiated exercise. The planned 50 megawatt solar farm is to be built in Kedah. It will be by far the largest in the country, especially if the 50 megawatt is proven to be merely a pilot, paving the way for a bigger scale solar panel project. Now, 1MDB solar farm initiative will also encroach upon TNB's space. Additionally, TNB's wholly owned subsidiary, TNB Energy Services Sdn Bhd, has been championing renewable energy, especially solar power, for years now. 1MDB's foray into solar power will only crowd out TNB and other smaller solar power players. The government must immediately explain why it decided to embark on a direct tender exercise in the case involving 1MDB when SEDA, the authority, previously has taken pains in the past to exercise open bidding through its transparent online open bidding systems for energy quota fixed between 1 megawatt to 5 megawatts in 2012. I think you're well aware of this issue. The government must also confirm the type of support provided to the project, whether through transmission from solar plant to grid, bridging any gap on funding grants, to the lease for the estimated 500-acre land needed for the entire project. Will it be this the usual private-public partnership project? We also deserve to know who is the technological partner or provider to 1MDB to ascertain the extent of risk exposure for 1MDB, which is now considered our national treasure.